Hi, I'm Josefina Estrada from Purdue University, bringing you the Boiler Bytes story of Sarag Saikia. Every semester, Purdue University selects 5 students from a group of nominees who are excelling in their respective areas of study. One student chosen for the 5 Students Who honor, PhD candidate Sarag Saikia, is working on expanding the possibilities of human exploration of our solar system.
I nominated Sarag to be one of the 5 students honored because of his mentorship, his research, his community contributions, and his enthusiasm for human and robotic space travel.
I'm deeply humbled and at the same time excited by all the opportunities I've been granted at Purdue University.
First of all, he has a tremendous knowledge of the history of spaceflight. Clearly, he studied this very deeply and broadly.
School of Aeronautics and Astronautics at Purdue University is one of the best schools in the area of space application and astrodynamics, and perhaps in the world. When I was in India doing my undergraduate studies, I read about a lot of the papers and the research publications written by the professors James Langusky and Kathleen Howell on the topics of interplanetary space mission design and celestial mechanics, spacecraft maneuvers, spacecraft attitude dynamics. And these were the subjects I really wanted to learn. So for me, it was a natural choice to be at Purdue for the grad studies.
Sarag's contributions align with the mission at Purdue very well. And in fact, in some areas, Sarag is taking a leading role in bringing collaborators and bringing scientists, engineers from prestigious positions in NASA and in academia to work together and to think about these problems that we have to face.
One of the problems I'm working on my doctoral research is to see how to land heavy mass on Mars of the order of hundreds of tons. And recently we started collaborating with NASA Ames Research Center, which has been developing the technology called ADAPT, or it's a mechanically deployable decelerator, which helps to decelerate in the thin atmosphere of Mars, which is a big challenge, and at the same time land with pinpoint accuracy. So we are developing the systems and then we are assessing the trajectories that can actually help us land heavy mass on Mars.
Sarag was invited by President Mitch Daniels to participate and to assist him. President Daniels was the co-chair of this National Committee for Human Spaceflight. And this was an opportunity to draw on Sarag's detailed and technical knowledge.
So in the spring of 2013, we were fortunate to meet President Daniels at the time, who just started with his tenure as the co-chair of the Committee on Human Spaceflight. And based on his suggestion, we started a student advisory group, which sat through a couple of meetings of the Committee on Human Spaceflight, and we were able to see for the firsthand how space policy deliberation takes place in the country. And then we provided, based on the meeting, we provided the recommendation to President Daniels in the form of a report. And I'm very glad to see when the final report was out a couple of months back that all these themes were featured in the final report as read out by President Daniels and Professor Jonathan Lunin from Cornell University, which they sought a couple of ways to focus on Mars and what they call the horizon goal of going to Mars, and all the technologies and all the policies should be directed at that in the long term.
I think that Mr. Sarag Saikia will be Professor Saikia. I'm hoping that he will get a position at a leading astronautics program and be able to continue to develop his ideas.
These are very exciting times, and I believe what it holds for the future is that in my generation, in the coming decades, I'll get to know some of the mysteries of the universe. As the Russian Konstantin Tsiolkovsky said, Earth is the cradle of humanity, but humans cannot live in the cradle forever. And it's all about human destiny, whether we'll stay here or we'll actually move outward.
Sarag has a very bright future, and I know that he's going to make his mark in his chosen field of astronautics. He has everything that it takes, and he's already making a mark. but I think you'll become a world-class leader in the area of human spaceflight and robotic missions.
That wraps up another Boiler Bytes. Be sure to check us out online at boilerbytes.com. We'll see you next time.